Here in Engaruka, a village in northern Tanzania, hardly anyone has a TV. That's why Linda Malimbo brings a small mobile cinema with her. She was here a few months ago on behalf of the LEED Foundation, a Tanzanian conservation organization.
I want to show a film about Kisikihai here today. Kisikihai means living tree stump. We will start with announcements in the village, and later in the evening, we will show the film.
But where is everyone? It's still early afternoon, and the villagers are in the fields, digging in the bone-dry earth. Holes in the earth as far as the eye can see. It seems like all 7,000 residents are out and about. What's going on? They're digging here because of another movie presented by Linda Malimbo and the LEED Foundation. It was called Just Dig It. John Mune remembers it well as he digs a trench and fills it with grass seed.
The film taught me that you can do something about the dryness and drought of recent years. We can till the land and create water basins, which we fill with seeds to help the fields recover.
In recent years, fields here have continued to fall victim to desertification. The persistent drought is a consequence of climate change. Can anyone really fight back? It's 5 p.m., and Linda Malimbo's colleague makes an announcement that the film screening is taking place that evening. It's a welcome change for the villagers. They only get to see a film every few months. The children are excited to see what's coming. Now the final touches. Linda Malimbo has been doing this for 3 years.
The film explains how to protect your land from drought. People have cut down their trees many times in recent years. The land became barren, and the harvests got worse. Now we want to show people how to reclaim that moisture so that their yields increase and they have enough pasture to feed their families.
It's finally showtime. It starts with Jay Mundy, a very popular comedian in Tanzania. Why he's riding a bicycle through the fields is a mystery. What's more important is what he hears. Everyone in Engaruka wants rain, and the film is well received. People here have become familiar with drought over the past few years, what it means to be thirsty all day long. The film showed the villagers that small shrubs or tree stumps can grow into large trees if given a chance. First, viable plants are selected. Next, they're pruned so that only the strongest shoots remain. Then the trees must be marked for everyone to see. And importantly, the plants must be protected from hungry cattle. According to the campaign, this method has managed to save over 9 million trees in Tanzania. A regreening measure of this magnitude has an impact on the local weather and can also bring rain. This means the country will cool down and crop yields will improve, at least in theory. In Engaruka, it's still a dream though. The last few months have seen 30% less precipitation than in previous years, which is one reason why they're digging the rain basins. According to the campaign, there are now over 200,000 such basins in Tanzania and Kenya. And all this just because people saw a movie. In reality, people here earn €1.50 per basin. Diligent workers like Dina Hosea can manage five a day.
We make money digging now. Later, when the grass is grown, it will benefit both our cattle and us because we save ourselves the trouble of carrying food to the cattle. If we employ these practices, they will help us take care of our livestock.
Rainwater normally evaporates on the dry soil, but now it can collect in the basins. This gives the water more time to seep into the soil, and this allows vegetation to grow not only inside the basins, but also all around them. This regreening program is in full swing and gaining in popularity. Strategies like this one have an impact on the global climate and could even help to slow down global warming. And the people of Engaruka are doing their part.